Hare Krishna.
Read scripture and read from scripture. Don't read into scripture. Scriptures like the Bhagavad Gita are meant to act as guidebooks for us in our day-to-day lives. And so in that sense, they are like roadmaps. So when we look at a roadmap, we read it. If it's a, if say we are doing academic study of the geography of America or India, then we may study the whole book, whole map. If you want to go on a particular route, then we may study that section of the map to know how to go. So these two are roughly analogous to reading scripture and reading from scripture. That means we read scripture systematically to understand the broad world view of scripture, to help us understand the terrain of life, to understand which choices which will lead to which consequences, and thereby make wise choices. We get the lay of the land. If we are living in a particular city, we just come to that city, then we may want to familiarize ourselves with the overall terrain of the city, even if we are, that is not on our daily path. So similarly, we can get an overall understanding of the scriptural worldview by reading scripture. And then whenever we face a particular temptation, a particular challenge, a particular dilemma, at that time, if we have marked out which sections of scripture particularly speak to us, then we may read from scripture. That means we may look at a particular section of scripture and read that, memorize that, contemplate that, analyze that, and then apply that in our own lives. So there is a systematic study of scripture, and there is a selective focus study of scripture when its particular sections speak to our needs. These two are very good, and the Bhagavad Gita recommends these two kinds of readings, broadly speaking, when it says in 16.24, Tasmat Shastram Pramanam Te Karya Karya Vyavasthitau Gyatva Shastra Vidhanoktam Karma Kartum Iharhasi Tasmat Shastram Pramanante. Therefore, understand with the authoritative knowledge that comes from Shastra, Karya Karya Vyavasthitau, which actions are to be done, which actions are not to be done. So which paths are to be followed, which paths are not to be followed. Just like on a road, some paths are one way, so they are not to be followed. And Gyatva Shastra Vidhanoktam. And then in this way, broadly understanding the guidelines of scripture, then karma kartum iharhasi, we can act appropriately. We can do the right karma. Karma kartum. So this way, if we act, then we will be able to move forwards in our life constructively. But sometimes, some people read into scripture. That means, if a child is looking at a map, and they may think, oh, this looks green. Is this some fruit to be eaten? This looks red. Is that an apple? And they may try to tear that and eat that. We may say that's absurd. Yes, even little older children won't do that. But reading into scripture means we come with a particular worldview and then start analyzing, deconstructing scripture from that worldview. That will lead to misunderstanding. So, for example, some people who have a anti-upper caste bias against broad Indian culture may see the Bhagavad Gita as a narrative of people given by the upper caste, and they will see everything in the Bhagavad Gita from that filter. Then they will not be able to benefit from the scripture. Some people may come with a nationalistic motive, and they may say that, oh, the Bhagavad Gita tells us to roll Arjun to fight a war. So similarly, we should fight a war against our enemies. But the Bhagavad Gita is not talking about war. The Bhagavad Gita is not a book of violence nor of silence. It is a book of transcendence. So if we read into scripture, then we won't benefit from scripture. We will simply use scripture to justify whatever we want to do. And that might give us some respect in a particular social circle, but that won't elevate our consciousness. That's why we need the guidance of those who have devoted their lives to living the Gita, to from them understand how to read scripture and how to read from scripture, and how to avoid reading into scripture. Thank you. Hare Krishna.